In this video, we're looking at the beta decay of C-14, and we're trying to compute the total energy released in this beta decay. We're given a table of reference values, so we're given the atomic mass unit in MeV per C squared, and I'll post a link real quick to a video where I showed how to convert kilograms into MeV per C squared, if you're curious. And then we have the mass of the C-14 atom, and we need to note really carefully here that we're talking about the entire atom, including the electrons. So this could be inconvenient for doing nuclear physics, but that's how these tables are normally arranged. So I have the mass of that nucleus plus its electrons. I'm also given the mass of the N14 atom, including all of its electrons. Finally, I clipped out a section of the periodic table involving these two elements, and I can see that this beta decay transforms that carbon nucleus into a nitrogen nucleus. And the process there is that a neutron will turn into a proton, and in the process, it's going to emit an electron. That's called beta radiation. To get into a little more detail of the reaction, this is what it looks like. I have carbon with its atomic number of 6, meaning 6 protons. Carbon-14 has 14 total nucleons, which means it has 8 neutrons. When it goes through this beta decay, one of the neutrons turns into a proton, giving me 7 protons. That's why I end up with nitrogen. I still have 14 total nucleons, which means 7 neutrons. In addition, an electron is going to fly out, and I could write that as a beta for this high-energy electron, and it has a charge of -1. And then just to throw in some detail that we're not even going to use, but just for completeness, an electron anti-neutrino is also emitted, and it has negligible mass. Now, depending on the angle between that neutrino and the beta particle, the electron may take all the energy of this decay or just a fraction of it. But in this problem, we're just trying to get the total energy released in the reaction. So the basic strategy here is to look at the mass of the thing we started with, and then look at the mass of what flies out of this reaction. And there should be some missing mass. And if we convert that to energy, we find out how much energy was released in the reaction. Now, a really common mistake for a beta decay is to include the mass of that electron. And this is really just an issue with the way the tables are designed here. So again, back here in the references, the mass of the C-14, the mass of the N-14, that includes their electrons. In other words, when I put in the mass of this N-14 on the right-hand side of the equation, it's going to include 7 electrons. When I put in the mass of this carbon on the left side of the equation, it's going to include the mass of 6 electrons. So just because of the way these tables are designed, I've already accounted for the mass of the beta particle on the right-hand side, and if I were to add in another electron mass, I'd be double counting. So now let's just write down what the initial mass was, and that's 14.003241 atomic mass units, but I want to get into MeV per C squared, so I'm just going to replace that atomic mass unit with 931.494, and this gives me 13,044. MeV per C squared. And then I look at the mass of everything that comes out of this reaction. And again, the mass of this nitrogen, the way the tables are designed, includes the extra electron already. And the mass of the neutrino is negligible. And this is where I realize I should have kept more precision in the mass of the C-14. The difference is so small, I'm going to have to go back and fix that in just a moment. So for the N14, that's 13,043.78. And when I go back and fix the precision on the C14, that was 13,043.93. Finally, I take the difference and I find the missing mass here. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 0.151 MeV per C squared of missing mass. Now, I still need to convert that to an energy, and maybe you can get casual enough where you just say it's going to be 0.151 MeV. But just to look under the hood for a second, what we're using is E equals MC squared. And we love these units for mass of MeV per C squared because they're so quick in this sort of calculation. So I have 0.151 MeV per C squared for the mass times C squared, and C squareds cancel. And I find out that the energy released in this reaction is 0.151 MeV. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.